Then I have to contact the British government, the foreign office there. Then I have, because I have to tell the people, I'm a good guy, but bad guy. Okay? And then when I arrive to Nairobi, I have to be with all the UN offices, telling them I want to have an access to this area. Then to other embassies, the Spanish embassy, and the other. Before I start, I have an access, not anyone. And this is my wallet. In the case of Syria, we've got a lot of amateur, mushrooming, Syrian, and Muslim organizations. Making a lot of problems, because we do not understand the mechanics of the security atmosphere, the intelligence atmosphere, the conflict zone. The Saudi law in the UK is being changed because of the diaspora Syrian organization. I'm not attacking them, no. I'm saying that this is a very, very difficult area for a very well established organization to have an access. Needless to say, a lot of the diaspora organizations in the West, okay, the Muslim ones especially, are just going there without having.
And that's why perhaps a council like this is needed. A council of elders.
I'm saying that we need this one. But you need to understand that as well, the atmosphere and the philosophy of thinking of the people, the decision makers. The decision makers are not the prime minister, I'm not the president, I'm not the king, I'm not the queen, I'm not the prince, or the sheriff. The decision makers are the security and the intelligence. Could be a security officer, or even a security minister.
Let's bring in Dr. Mohammed.